Welcome to sunny Malta, to the Malta Eurovision Song Contest 2017. That's the competition Malta selects their song for the Eurovision Song Contest 2017 that's been happening in Kiev on the 9th, 11th and 13th of May. And we're back at Ta'ali, that's where the national finals usually took place in the past. Last year was at the MCC, the Mediterranean Conference Center, but now we're back at the Malta Fairs and Convention Center. And with us now is one of the newcomers to the competition. She is one of the 16 artists competing for the ticket to go to represent Malta at the Eurovision in Kiev later on in May. It is Miriana Conte. Hi, nice to meet you, Miriana. How are you?
Same here, I'm fine.
You're fine?
Yes.
So you've been on the stage just now to rehearse?
Yes, second time?
Was it the second time?
Yes, the second time it was. I had a lot of fun today.
Okay, how was it for you? Can you describe a bit how you perform your song?
It's sort of a chill song, but the crowd can dance with it still because mm-hmm. It's a bit reggae R&B, and so you can like jam with it.
Super. What is for you the animation to take part in this national final?
You have to be like continuously going to programs and rehearsals. You have to rehearse continuously, mm-hmm. but it's fun.
Well, you're a new face to the national final here in Malta, Can you tell us a bit about your musical background? How did you come into becoming a singer?
I basically started singing when I was 5 years old, and I started vocal lessons also. And singing was always inside of me, my mom tells me. Like, mm-hmm. instead of talking, I used to sing. And then I continued. I started at La Voix Academy, coached mm-hmm. by Gelina Tard.
Yep.
And I took part in Sanremo Junior, Io Canto, and various others in Italy.
Mm-hmm. So you're very young. How old are you now? I know we shouldn't ask ladies, but you're still very young.
I'm 16.
16?
I'm
wow.
I'm the smallest one.
Like wow.
There are three of us which are 16. Mm-hmm. Shauna, Jade and me, but I'm the smallest from once.
Wow. So you're still going to school as well?
Yes. I study performing arts.
Oh, excellent. Fantastic. So how did the love for arts come on for you? Is it something that came by birth, or what animated you to become an artist, basically?
I also loved theater as a child. Mm-hmm. And when I finished secondary school, I said, like, I'm going to stop, like, because I used to take part in the school plays mm-hmm. and musicals. And I wanted to carry on my studies in performing arts, so...
And now you're here on the big stage trying to get the ticket for Eurovision 2017. You know that there's millions of people, like 200 million people watching this contest. Are you not afraid of this amount of people that are watching it in case you do get the ticket to go to Eurovision?
We like spend months preparing for this, so why be afraid? Like, we have to give a show to the people.
Very good answer. Really good. Amazing. When you finished the studies, what is your aim to become after that?
I want to maybe be a vocal coach.
Okay. So more as a singer, or you want to be a singer or a vocal coach or actress maybe?
I'm still not sure because you never know what might happen mm-hmm. during the year. But I want to carry on my studies abroad or something. Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about the song that you have in the running. It's called Don't Look Down. Cyprien Cassa and Matt Mouchou wrote the song.
That's right.
It's a big songwriting team here in Malta. And, uh-huh. and how did they find you to sing the song?
I go to vocal lessons with Mouchou. Like previously, like in the previous mm-hmm. years, I did songs with Mouchou and Cyprien, so I chose to collaborate with them both for the Eurovision, obviously.
Mm-hmm. Do you sing, this song is in English, it's called Don't Look Down, it's in English,
yes.
but do you also sing in Maltese?
Yes, of course.
Can you give us a bit of an example of a Maltese song?
Maltese song, Shemsh, you know Shemsh?
Do it.
Shemsh wisaviha lile kinho.
That's a bit of a Maltese by Miriana. That's very nice. Thank you very much for doing that. The song itself, can you tell us what is the content of the song, the message you want to bring across with it?
Basically, the song talks about my past, because I was bullied because of, like, weight and, mm-hmm. like, everything. And I never managed to get rid of these people, like previously they carry on. I know because even on work placements, mm-hmm. like older people, they still get bullied. So that's the message I want to carry out. Like, never look down, keep your self-esteem, and don't let them take your crown. Like, keep your standards high.
Well, that's a very good answer. That's what many people should be taking this for to also live that message.
Yes,
basically. Over the years, Malta has had a lot of huge hits at the Eurovision Song Contest. Do you have any favorite songs from Malta that went to Eurovision?
Yes, Ember.
Which ones?
Ember, Warrior.
Warrior, wow, yes. Fantastic, super. And from the national finals, away from the winners?
I used to love Israel's song, Golden Boy.
Oh, okay, yeah.
And Australia.
Dame Im?
Last year,
The Sound of Silence, yeah. Talking about this now, would you be wanting to cover a Eurovision song maybe one day?
Yes, of course.
Which one would that be?
Sound of Silence. It's very
Sound
nice.
Of Silence, wow. Amazing. It's a very, very tough song to sing, actually.
Uh-huh,
it's very tough. If you were to sing a song with somebody together, a duet, let's go for Maltese and also for an international artist.
Maltese, I would sing with Daniel Testa.
Daniel, who's on Bay
89.7.
On Bay Radio here in Malta. So, why Daniel?
Because I love his voice and his style also. He has a very powerful voice.
Okay, yeah, excellent. An international artist, who would that be?
Beyoncé, for sure.
Wow.
For sure.
Some big things there. What are your first memories of the Eurovision Song Contest? When did you start watching it?
I used to view it from when I was a child, always. There's a story, I always tell it.
Tell us, that's
cool. I was one, and the Roloska represented Malta with Seventh Wonder. And they used to put me on a stool at the grocery shop, and I used to sing Seventh Wonder.
With 1 year of age?
Yes.
Wow. You're really a true singer from the heart.
Yes, maybe. Yes.
With one year of singers, a plane coming in, more tourists coming. Well, fantastic. Now, this year's slogan, it's a tough question now. This year's slogan is Celebrate Diversity. That's a Eurovision slogan. What would you suggest for next year?
Unite as one, maybe.
Very good, fantastic, very quick thinking. Wow, fantastic. What's in the future for you music-wise? Are you going to continue working with Mushu and Cyprian, or you have some other teams you want to join in? And what's your vision for the future in music?
Mushu always helps me, motivates me, even Cyprian, so I might keep the same team, I think. Mm-hmm. But who knows what might happen in the future.
Okay, you never know. Well, Miriana, thank you very much for taking the time to chat with
thank
us.
You.
And of course, before we leave, can we have a bit of the song that you're going to be competing with at the Malta Eurovision Song Contest?
Sure.
It's called Don't Look Down.
Don't look down. Show them what you're made of. Don't look down. Live a life you will remember. Singing din da da din da da bom bom, yeah. Din da da din da da bom bom. Don't look down.
Fantastic, thank you so much.